In today's video, we are going to discuss freeing node resources using container garbage collection. Container garbage collection can be performed using eviction threshold. We will discuss eviction soft and eviction hard parameters in the OpenShift. Stay tuned to get more information on this parameter. Hey, it's Praveen Mali here from GeekSurf, where I talk about technical stuff. If you are seeing value in this video, make sure you give it a thumbs up and click on subscribe button. It's really make a huge difference. Let's jump into it. As an administrator, you can use OpenShift container platform to ensure that your nodes are running efficiently by freeing up resources through garbage collection. Container garbage collection can be performed using eviction threshold. When eviction thresholds are set for garbage collection, and if thresholds are met for parameters like eviction soft or eviction hard, then the node takes the appropriate action. So, what is the eviction soft? A eviction soft threshold has a grace period. Once the grace period is over, node attempts to reclaim resources. Let's talk more on this. If a soft eviction threshold is met, independent of its associated grace period, the node reports a condition to indicate that the node is under memory or disk pressure. Reporting the pressure prevents the scheduler from scheduling any additional pods on the node while it attempts to reclaim resources. Now, what is eviction hard? A hard eviction threshold does not have any grace period. When node reaches a hard limit, it takes immediate action to reclaim the process. Let's try to understand eviction using a diagram. Here you can see that node has some workload as pods are running on it. Scheduler is scheduling more pods on the node. Eventually, node reaches the threshold limit. Now, node sends a signal to scheduler to stop scheduling more pods on it. Scheduler stops the scheduling new pods on the node. In meantime, node tries to reclaim resources by deleting pod. Here you can see that pod 1 is deleted. Now pod 2 is deleted. Now pod 5 is deleted. Now node is adjusting the resources as resources is available. Node stop request is completed and now scheduler starts the scheduling pods on the node, and this continues in a cycle until the node hits threshold. Let's look at the example for memory pressure on node. We want the pods to be evicted when memory.available reaches to 2 GB. For that, we have to add eviction parameters in the kubelet config file. Let's look at the kubelet config file. Here you can see that eviction parameters are added in the kubelet config section under the spec sections. This is the one. This is the kubelet config section, which is under the spec section. In eviction hard parameter, if memory.available reaches to 2 GB, then the node will directly start to remove the pods from it and will not wait for anything. And if you look at the eviction soft parameter, so when memory.available reaches to 2.5 G, then node will wait for 1 minute before removing the pod from it. The reason for node waiting is we have configured eviction soft grace period over here. Let's create a kubelet config file. Before that, just let me open a new window and check the node status continuously. Okay, I can see that all the nodes are in the ready state and working. Let me just create a kubelet config file. Let's see, create hyperjammer kubelet of eviction.yammer. Okay, now we can see that kubelet config is created. Let me check one more time. Let's see, get kubelet config. Okay, we can see that custom kubelet hard soft eviction, that is kubelet config, is created. Just now look at the another window. Here you can see that all the worker nodes are becoming a not ready state. To take the changes, we have built the kubelet config. So it will do for all the worker nodes and it will take some time. Let me just pause the video over here and we'll be back when all the worker nodes and all the master nodes are in ready state. Now you can see all the nodes are in the ready state. Okay, let me move to the another tab. Okay, let me put some load on the worker nodes and see if node removes the pod from it. But first, let me create a new namespace. Let's see. Project. Then. So, okay, so basically, what we are doing, I have created a new namespace, is a name as a name. And now I will create a pod and putting a load on the nodes. Okay, so let's create a new pods on this namespace. So basically what we are doing, I have created a new namespace as a main, and now I'm creating 10 pods in the same namespace so that the nodes can have some load on it. So let's start. See create hyphen a mo of eviction.net. Okay, let me move to the another tab and let's do the watch for main namespace. Okay, as of now there are no pods in main namespace. Let's run our command and see how it's going. Oops. Okay, now you can see the pods are creating. Let's check here. So let's just, you know, what's the status part over here. So now the pods are creating on the main namespace and creating a load on the particular nodes. Let's wait. Okay, now we can see that the container status is changed to unknown. Now we will wait for all the pods status to change to be, you know, the overkill or the error. The reasons for the pods are changing their status is because we have set the eviction parameters in the kubelet config. Right? Once that eviction threshold is met, the pod is trying to kill all those pods. Okay, now we have seen that all pods are deleted. Okay, let's check the logs for the nodes. We'll check this worker node. Okay, now we'll check the logs. Here we can see that our eviction threshold is already met and the kubelet is already attempted to reclaim the memory. This is how the eviction parameters work with this.